Hello everyone, my name is Krzysztof Książek, I'm Director of Support at Severalnines, and in this very quick talk I would like to go over the cases why your MariaDB cluster will crash. So, first of all, I want you to assume that this will happen, the crash will happen. It helps to assume that because then you can focus on the planning, how you will deal with the issue, rather than considering if it will happen, how probably it is. I mean, it will, at some point in time, it just will. And there are a couple of typical issues that may break your cluster. Those are the network issues, hardware issues, and the issues triggered by the user. So, network issues. MariaDB cluster, as every Galera cluster, is strictly tied to network. It's just a bunch of nodes connected over the network. So the data is being replicated over the network. The intra-cluster communication goes over the network. So basically, like heartbeats, like quorum calculation, everything goes through the network. So if the network goes down, the nodes cannot communicate and the cluster fails. Therefore, the network partitioning is pretty much the most common case where Galera crashes. So we're talking here about situation where you have multiple nodes, you know, 3, 5, 7, 9, whatever. And then the majority of them loses the communication with the rest of the cluster. This makes it, you know, this turns the cluster into non-primary state. It loses the quorum and it ceases to operate. So it stops executing any kind of queries. And this is mostly because to protect the data consistency. But technically speaking, cluster is down. Speed drain, another problem. So right, we are talking here about a situation where you have a cluster which is due to network issues split into two parts, for example, and both of those parts are working, both of them are executing queries. As you can imagine, it's quite bad for the data consistency. Theoretically speaking, it shouldn't happen because of this non-primary state, because of those precautions, but we are talking about software, so even if it's unlikely, it still may happen, right? Bugs, right, conditions, this something may just trigger this. Also, MariaDB cluster by default is quite well configured for the local network. But if you want to use it like in a geographically distributed cluster, then you need to account for higher latency, you know, distance. You need to account for the links that are not as stable as the local network. And basically, you probably want to do add some tuning just to make sure that your heartbeats, that your, you know, health checks are not timing out because of the network issues rather than the node health issues. Hardware. So there's always hardware somewhere, no matter how you hide it behind the scenes. And hardware can break. You know, there are physical parts like CPU, memory, disk, power supply, network controllers, whatever. They just may break. If you have access to the hardware, then you can apply some redundancy on the hardware level. If not, which is, well, quite common these days, you probably want to account for node crashes on higher level, like put at, like maybe instead of 3 nodes, add the 5 nodes in your MariaDB cluster. Also, network, you know, CPU, disk saturation, you know, you can run out of resources, and node which run out of resources is typically slow node. Then it may not be able to respond in timely manner for the health checks within the MariaDB cluster, and such node can be evicted from the cluster. So you want to be aware of this kind of situation. You want to have a proper monitoring and alerting that just alerts you, okay, your node is running out of CPU, and you probably want to do something about it. Users, they can break the cluster as well. So everyone with the access to the database has the potential to crash it or impact its operations. So developers, they can run schema changes. Well, I mean, for Nextcloud, maybe that's not that common, but it still may happen that you want to run some alters to create some indexes. And by default, running alter on MariaDB cluster just stops the cluster for every kind of operation until the alter completes. So you should probably use some tools like ptonline schema change instead, rather than running the alters directly. Also, you may want to write to all of the nodes in MariaDB cluster, but you shouldn't. It's better, it's more stable, it's less contention when you use one writer in a cluster. You can apply this, you can configure load balancers to do this. Also, you know, the generic configuration, like there are a couple of different elements in MariaDB cluster. SST, for example, is a process to recover the node, to transfer the data from the cluster to failed node. It can be misconfigured and the recovery may not happen. Even just simple configuration setting, if mistype, like you mistype some variable in MariaDB configuration file, it may trigger MariaDB just not to start at all, right, after the restart. So you should be looking for logs. You should be looking just to check out what kind of issues are there. Maybe there are clues how to, typically there are clues how to recover from such a problem. So there are two more talks from Severalnines. Vinay Josery, Severalnines CEO, has a talk on high-availability database architecture for Nextcloud. And my colleague Ashraf Sharif has a workshop on tips to drive MariaDB cluster performance for Nextcloud. Thank you very much for listening.